It's a big honor for two Sacramento County educators. Last night, Janet Anderson and Sylvia Rodriguez were named Teachers of the Year. And they're joining us in studio this morning. Thanks for coming in to both of you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, Janet, you're a third grade teacher at Elliott Ranch Elementary. What went through your mind last night? I mean, you knew it was a possibility, but when they actually say your name, what was that like?
I kept thinking there's some other third grade Elliott Ranch Janet Anderson in the crowd. I was just very surprised, very shocked. I don't think it was up until I was on stage that I actually realized that, oh, it was me.
So what does it mean to you to be named like that?
Well, it's a huge honor. You know, when parents bring their children and give them to me, you know, I've got 20 families every morning that expect me to do the best with their kids, and it just inspires me every day, and it just means that all the work that, you know, as teachers we put into it, and all the creative ways we have to work around, you know, reaching expectations of our children, that it just means a lot. Big honor to be recognized for that.
Sylvia, you teach fifth grade in the GATE program at Phoebe Hearst Elementary. How long have you been teaching?
This is my eighth year teaching.
And so what was it about teaching that kind of drew you? Because there are a lot of other jobs that, quite frankly, would be a lot easier than what you both do. What was it that drew you into it?
I actually used to report, and so I was in Fairfield covering politics and government, and I think it was just seeing that the people were often so frustrated not knowing how they could make a change and how they could help to affect rules and policies. And so I decided to start at the beginning, and maybe I could help people to learn how they could be empowered to make those changes in life.
And so just 8 years later to be recognized like this.
Yeah, it was amazing. I was honored to be there in the presence with teachers who have so much experience, and they were still so motivated and so driven, and I was in awe of all the teachers that were there last night. It was really motivational and inspirational for me.
Do you remember the teacher who influenced both of you as you were growing up?
Go ahead.
Mine was my fourth grade teacher, Mrs. Gonadovich, in Las Vegas, Nevada, and she was a creative teacher who offered me extra help, and I just felt, you know, I felt real love from her, and I felt like she really cared about what I was doing and how I was learning, so she was my inspiration.
I think I had a lot of them. I just, one stands out would be my fourth grade teacher who used to do some really crazy science experiments that now would just shut down the school. You cannot explode things in the classroom and have live animals running around.
But I know, things aren't as much fun anymore,
no.
Are they? That's great. Well, I know you guys get to class here in about a half hour. Do you need a note or something? I'm sure Chris Reaver would be glad to write you one. He's writing it right now. Thanks to both of you. Congratulations.